This video series was produced from the Autism Mental Health Literacy Guide by the Autism Mental Health Literacy Project, AM Help Group. This video is one of six in the series about different aspects of autism mental health literacy. For this video, we will talk about understanding autistic well-being. We briefly explore what well-being means, what it looks like, and how we can support it. You can learn more about this topic in the AM Help Guide. Well-being is broad and different for each person, especially day-to-day. Many factors can influence it. Well-being is based on how people feel and on their contexts. For example, there are outside factors, like social connections or accessibility, and internal factors, like how a person copes, their optimism, or their self-esteem. There are several aspects of well-being: psychological, emotional, physical, social, spiritual. Autistic people have fulfilling lives and experience well-being.
Autistic folks do have fun. We do build coping skills. We do have enjoyable things that make our lives worthwhile. Our lives are treated by society as being the worst case scenario. Like my birth was nothing to be celebrated. But that's not true. I have fun. I have favorite toys and games. I like to draw and read. I look forward to comic book conventions. I love Christmas and Halloween. I have a full life, not a tragedy.
Self-care and community care are both important things to consider when it comes to autistic well-being. Self-care is the many ways people can attend to their own needs, keep themselves feeling as well as possible, and have positive mental health. It's about taking care of yourself, but this can also include other people helping you take care of yourself. Self-care looks different for everyone and is not something that is always done by itself. For some, self-care may mean connecting with others, getting and giving support. For others, it may mean taking a break from connecting with others.
I choose to find value in crafting, sewing, gardening, and home improvements, all activities that are home-based, and I only shop locally, a short walk from home. I prioritize family and friends, and have people over for tea in the garden or barbecues in good weather. Music and art, reading and learning are all positive activities that can be fulfilled over the internet. I enjoy teaching and offer sewing and crafting on a one-on-one basis. My life is balanced and fulfilling.
You can engage in short and long-term self-care strategies. Short-term strategies can be done to immediately boost well-being. For example, you can go to a quiet room, eat your favorite food, or talk to a trusted person.
I have a self-care shoebox where I put in a few small candy bars, some video games and movies, fidget toys and the like. Or at times I say to myself, how can I relax today? And make a list of activities I would find enjoyable and pick a few from the list.
Long-term strategies are strategies that can be done over time and can maintain your well-being. For example, being informed about your mental health, learning about your mental health, and how to support it.
Diagnosis is kind of a double-edged sword. On the one hand, it gives clarity and understanding of who you are and what you need, but at the same time, it gives you something to point at and say, I'm less than. There's a lot of internalized ableism that comes with it. But on the flip side, withholding diagnostic information can result in a lot of confusion and even self-hatred that you just can't explain. With a diagnosis, you're actually able to work through whatever it is you're going through and able to speak to someone about it using the right terminology.
Building social support.
Quand j'ai reçu mon diagnostic pour la première fois, il n'y avait pas de groupe pour les adultes autistes dans ma communauté. Bien que j'ai trouvé ça décourageant au début, j'ai créé mon petit cercle de soutien en créant d'abord un tel groupe localement qui était de nature sociale et récréative. Ensuite, j'ai créé un groupe de soutien dirigé par des autistes qui se réunit tous les mois. Ces possibilités ont fourni à d'autres comme moi un endroit doux pour atterrir pour les niveaux diagnostiqués. Pour les adultes autistes de ma communauté, Cela a permis d'avoir un endroit pour relier et valider nos expériences et pour favoriser la fierté autiste.
Practicing autistic pride. Being proud to be autistic and celebrating how autistic people communicate, experience, and understand the world around them.
I think pride is something that one practices, not just experiences. Pride wasn't given to me from the sky. I had to work on it like a skill. If I don't practice it regularly, it is hard to stay proud, especially when the whole world is constantly gearing up to tell me I am not worthy of pride.
When we talk about self-care, we can't assume that everyone has the ability to do it and access support on their own. This is also why it is important to talk about community care when we talk about well-being.
One of my biggest and most successful self-care strategies is asking for help. I pose questions to similarly affected individuals, and I ask for advice on how they've solved the same problems I'm dealing with. Hearing from other people who are like me and who have shared lived experience is one of the most hopeful and helpful parts of self-care that I do for myself. It makes me feel like I'm not alone. It also helps me to organize to remove these problems and barriers for others, and that helps me to cope.
Community care is choosing to take care of each other, including oneself and others in the community. Examples of community care are peer groups or neighborhood groups, sometimes called spoon shares or pods, that connect people needing short or long-term support because of injury, illness, or other life challenges. Mutual aid is when we provide social support or resources to each other, like running errands for someone in need or food to people when they cannot afford it. These groups work to meet each other's needs to survive. Some resources that can be given or asked for in community care include practical help, like household chores, travel assistance, sharing experiences, and more. Offering, asking, receiving, or declining help may not come easily to an autistic person, especially if they have mental health challenges. However, community care works based on support and understanding, and you don't have to get it right the first time.
Community care improves well-being just as much, if not more, than self-care. Overemphasis on self-care is one of the ways society fails at securing the well-being of disabled people.
It is not up to the autistic person alone. To feel capable and successful, autistic adults may need some support at home, school, work, and more. One of the ways society can change is to make things more universally accessible. This means creating and designing projects and environments that allow everyone with all levels of ability to access, understand, use, and participate in society. For example, providing gender-neutral and wheelchair-accessible washrooms, providing augmentative and alternative communication tools, or flexible work hours. Thriving often takes a combination of understanding autism, knowing what self-care works for each person, and having autistic adults, service providers, and family members, the community, working together. Knowing more helps more. This project is funded by the Public Health Agency of Canada.